Hey guys.
Hey Bo.
Hi Bo.
Flippin' physics.
Ladies and gentle people, the bell has rung, therefore class has begun, therefore you should be seated in your seat, ready and excited to do an example problem about average velocity.
Yep.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Here we go. Bo, please read the problem.
Buster and Mr. P embark on a walk. If they leave Mr. P's house, travel a distance of 1.2 kilometers and return back to his house 12 minutes and 13 seconds later, A, what was their average speed, and B, what was their average velocity? Give answers in meters per second.
Why do all these examples have to do with walking his dog?
The dog needs to, you know, do his business.
I bet I can figure out where he lives from that map. Although it looks like he removed the street names.
Dude, that's just rude.
We know he's from Texas.
What?
Why? Isn't it obvious?
You clearly missed the Steelers jersey.
You know I can hear you. I'm right here. And y'all should know where I live anyway. You are in my basement.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
But how did we get here?
All right, this is just strange. Let's get back to the problem. Bo, could you please read? And Bobby, could you please translate?
Buster and Mr. P embark on a walk. If they leave Mr. P's house and travel a distance of 1.2 kilometers and return back to his house 12 minutes and 13 seconds later...
Please stop. Distance equals 1.2 kilometers and time equals 12 minutes and 13 seconds.
Yep. Bo, please continue.
A, what was their average speed? And B, what was their average velocity? Give answers in meters per second.
Part A, average speed equals question mark. And part B, average velocity equals question mark. Oh, and add the meters per second for each one.
Billy, please solve part A.
Speed equals distance over time, so we can write out that equation. But we should convert to meters and seconds first. So multiply the distance by 1,000 meters over 1 kilometer to get the distance in meters, which works out to be 1,200 kilometers. And multiply the 12 minutes by 60 seconds over 1 minute, and add the 13 seconds to that, and you get 733 seconds for the time. Then we can substitute those numbers back into our equation for speed, and we get 1.63711 meters per second, and that rounds to two sig figs, 1.6 meters per second with two sig figs.
Very nice, Billy. That is the average speed. Bo, how about part B, the average velocity?
No. I got it. You just add direction because speed is just velocity without direction. Oh, dang it, Blast. We don't know anything about direction. Actually, Billy, unfortunately, that's not right, and that is the main point of this example problem. The fact that speed and velocity are not the same thing, and speed is not the velocity without direction. I'm going to say that again because it's so important, and that's the point of this lesson. Speed is not the velocity without the direction. Bo, could you please answer the problem?
Well, again, I'm going to continue to learn from the past and start with the equation. Velocity equals displacement over time.
Yes, Bobby, this is delta x displacement on the top. Remind me, delta is an equation, and what does that mean, and what does x mean?
We just learned this. Delta is always final minus initial, and x is position. So delta x is the final position minus the initial position.
Yes, another way of saying displacement is it is position final minus position initial. So, Billy, what do we get then for position final minus position initial? What is the displacement? Buster and Mr. Palmer went for a walk, but what was their total displacement? In other words, what was the straight line distance from where they started to where they ended?
Zero. They started and ended in the same spot, so their total displacement is zero.
That makes their average velocity also equal to zero.
This is the whole point of this example problem. The basic idea that velocity and speed are not the same, and speed is not velocity without direction.
Not true.
In this particular example, the velocity was zero, the speed was 1.6 meters per second. You can see that those are two very different things. The reason for that was because Buster and I started and ended at the same point. The straight line distance from the initial to the final points was equal to zero. Therefore, the displacement is equal to zero. Therefore, the average velocity was equal to zero. However, we did travel. Therefore, our distance traveled was not zero. Therefore, our average speed was not zero. Again, velocity and speed are not the same thing, and speed is not velocity without direction. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.
Lecture notes are available at flippingphysics.com. Please enjoy lecture notes responsibly.